Hi everyone, it's Neil Patel, and today I'm going to teach you how to come up with over 1,000 blog post ideas in less than a minute. So I want you to head to Ubersuggest, and I'm going to be breaking down the exact process I use to come up with blog post ideas for my own blog, Neil Patel. And this works for any industry. So I want you to head over to Ubersuggest and just type in any keyword related to your space. So let's say I type in digital marketing because I have a blog that covers SEO, pay-per-click advertising, social media marketing, online marketing. It literally covers all aspects of marketing. Now, when you land here and you type in a general broad term, which is your goal, you don't want to go too specific. Type in something that's more general that gets some search traffic, ideally something that gets more than 1,000 visitors a month. And you'll see data on the traffic, and as you scroll down you'll see more keyword ideas, but I want you to scroll all the way to the bottom and click on content ideas. Now click view all. This report here breaks down all the blog posts on the web around this topic, and this blog report sorts these blog posts based off of social shares. Now just because someone has a lot of social shares, it doesn't mean they have a lot of SEO traffic. You can have pages that get a ton of social shares that have very little SEO traffic. And what you'll find is typically posts that have a lot of social shares get very little organic traffic because Google is looking, most people are typing in that how-to stuff when they're doing research on Google, but a lot of people on the social web don't care to share that content. But if you take your time, you can find some articles that get some social shares and some search traffic as well. So throughout this report, I want you to scroll, and it may take you a while. You may have to end up going to the next page and next page, and you want to look for the gems. You don't want to just write on the stuff that everyone else is writing on, and this is why most people don't get tons of traffic, because this column here, the estimated visits, shows you how much Google traffic something gets. This here tells you how much social traffic something gets, and this here shows you how many backlinks an article may get. So as you scroll, you'll find stuff that has a little bit of everything. Now, this one is the 10 essential tips for B2B marketing success in a digital economy. As you can see, they get some SEO traffic, some social traffic, and a good amount of backlinks. Now, that's not bad. Even if this article doesn't get a lot of search traffic, it gets some. Those backlinks help your whole site and all your other pages to get more Google traffic as well. So when I look at this, I'll click through at this article and I'll be like, okay, the 10 essential tips for B2B marketing success in a digital economy. I'll accept the cookies. And then I go look at this. This article is written in November 2014. Old article. Doesn't mean anything's wrong. It's just Google likes ranking fresh content. So if this article was much more fresh, it probably would be getting more traffic, but it's not. It was written in November 12, 2014. And if you look at this, it's talking about the 10 essential tips. Look at the tips. Tip one, being found. Okay? It's not long tips. Look how basic they are. And I'm not trying to talk crap about the writer, but that's your opportunity. It's really short. It doesn't provide a lot of details. There's no images. They're just linking to other articles. They're not giving step-by-step instructions or any of that. So if I create an article that was much more detailed, like this one says, the website, your digital kingdom. And most companies know they need a website, but they don't recognize just how critical it is. Your website is your digital kingdom, a place where you can share your brand story, connect with people directly to your company, and make that all-important first impression. Make sure your online presence is up to par by having engaging customer experience, top-notch branding, and easy navigation. Also notice spelling error. Make sure your online presence. So you forgot the R, which is fine. I make a ton of grammar and spelling errors myself. But he talks about having a website, but he doesn't break down how to create one if no one has one. Maybe you go to WordPress.com. Maybe you go to Wix. Maybe you go to Shopify. These are all places I can link people to, and I can break down how to set up a WordPress site, a Wix website, a Shopify site. That's an example of getting more detailed. Or if I don't want to break down how to do it, I can link to other guides around the web that teach you how to set up a Shopify site, a Wix site, a Squarespace site. And when you break this down, it makes your article more detailed. And I can do that for each and every single point. Now, when you look at this article, I want you to go back to Ubersuggest. You can see 124 estimated visits from Google, and you can see marketing to business. His rankings aren't that high. A lot of it has to do with the age of the article. So if the article was continually updated, he would get way more traffic, right? Some of these keywords are lucrative, and you can see that from the high CPC. In addition to that, if you write an article on the same topic, but you make it your own, you don't plagiarize, you write something that's better, more detailed, and you go after all the terms that they're getting traffic for, like marketing to B2B, not ranking high enough, but if you started ranking high for these terms, you can get way more than 124 visitors. You can get thousands of visitors, literally each and every single month. And I want you to do is look at the keywords that that article ranks for, and you just click on keywords next to the visit count, and you'll see a list of keywords. And you can keep clicking next, next, next if that article ranks for a ton of keywords, or you can just export them, and they'll export them all to CSV so you have them. And then the next thing I want you to do is take those keywords when you write your own version and make sure you include those. At the same time, you've already exported them, you want to look at all the people that are linking to that article, right? And you can see here all the sites linking to them. And, you know, some of them are probably detailed, some of them are not. It doesn't matter. And you can click on some of these links. Trigger Mine. Let's go to this. All right. So you can see Trigger Mine is linking to it. This article is written in 2017. And, you know, it's just detailed content. And it's not too detailed in length, but they're linking to it. So what you want to do is you want to take a list of all of these sites that are linking to the article. And you want to either write them all down, or you can also export them. Because when you write your article, you want to hit up each of these site owners and talk about how you have a more detailed article that's on a similar topic, but it provides more steps, more actions, more strategy. It's more step-by-step with screenshots, video tutorials. And when it's so much better, you're going to get a lot of people willing to link to you, especially because yours is fresh, new, and it's not outdated, while this one was written in 2014. That's old. So when you do that, people are much more likely to link to you. Now, going back to this, I have one final tip for you. When you're writing your piece of content, I want you to take some of the keywords like marketing to business and all the popular ones, put them in the keyword ideas report. So I want you to go to keyword ideas, type in that keyword, and what Ubersuggest will show you is all the other keywords that are similar that you can include in your article, like marketing business online, marketing businesses on social media. And then you would also want to click on related keywords, and it'll show you all the related keywords and show you all the questions, and it'll give you more keyword ideas and all the prepositions and comparisons. Now, some of these keywords won't be related to the article that you're writing. Some of them will be. For the ones that are and make sense, include them in your article because it'll be extra traffic that you can get. And that's how you outrank your competition, get more ideas, and rank even higher. Now, if you have any questions on how you can write an article that ranks higher and beats your competition when you're going through this process, if you're confused on any step, just leave a comment below and I'll answer and help you out. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like it, subscribe to it, share it with your friends. Subscribe to the channel, of course. And if you need help improving your rankings, your traffic, you can always check out my ad agency, Neil Patel Digital. Thank you for your time.